Tammy Faye, outspoken activist Chastity Bono, and one of the hottest fans around, Blues Traveler is here. And now here's Roseanne.
And then they said my name, so I had to chew it real fast. Thank you. I love you too. What's our topic today?
Topic is kids.
Okay, you want to ask me some questions about kids? Yes, ma'am.
Roseanne, has your little son, has he asked you where babies come from?
Nope.
What would you tell him if he did ask you?
Well, I think I would tell him the truth if he did ask me. But I'm hoping that doesn't happen till my other kids, like when they were in their 20s. I'm hoping I don't have to deal with it at all. Because it's embarrassing, and I hate admitting that that's where, you know, they came from. It's embarrassing that we do stuff like that. Yes.
Now, what age would you let your daughter start to wear makeup?
I guess 14. For just for the boys. We have a great show today. We have Chastity Bono is here with her fascinating new book called Family Outing. We have the Grammy-winning band, Blues Traveler. And my first guest has lost three houses, three luxury cars, a staff of 3,000, and a husband. But since then, she's beaten cancer and made this hilarious appearance on the Drew Carey Show.
Did you know that my little princess was third in her class at finishing school?
I would have been in her place.
Oh, so here he is.
Don't tell me you're Mimi's mom.
Yes. And you'll have to excuse me, because I barely had time to put my face on.
Hey, you got somebody's face on.
Here to tell us how she survived, please welcome Tammy Faye.
Roseanne, I asked to be on your show because I think you're doing a great job.
Oh, thank you very much.
And I think we're very similar ladies.
I think we are too.
We're both tough old broads that have just fought through and made it, and I'm glad to see you all here still fighting.
Thank you.
And I think you're beautiful. Does she not have the most beautiful face you've ever seen? Woo! You really do.
Why, thank you.
You do.
You know, but you shouldn't say that to a fat woman. You know what that means.
You are not fat. You are getting really skinny.
I know, but I'm still fat, Tammy Faye.
No,
and
you're
you
not.
You shouldn't say, I am, I'm
That's
still fat.
They used to tell me that I had a beautiful face, and I'd say, well, what about the rest of my body?
You know what that means. You say that to a
you're
fat woman.
You're just flat beautiful.
Thank you.
You are. You really
but
are.
I have to tell you what it means when you tell a fat person that they're fat.
What do you tell them?
That means you'd be good looking as a head.
Well, they told me that too, so we're together.
You're a beautiful woman too.
They told me
in
that.
And out.
My girlfriend used to say, Tammy, you have such a pretty face. She said, you'd be so pretty if you'd lose a little weight. She actually told me that. Yeah, but that's a good girlfriend that'll tell you that.
No, that isn't.
That's not fooling around with you, you know.
That's not a good girlfriend.
You don't think so?
No. Why do people feel like they have to tell you
I know,
stuff?
They always feel like they have to, don't they?
They have to criticize something about you constantly, huh?
Yeah, all the time.
People criticize you about your makeup all the time. How mad does that make you?
You know, it's gotten to where I just laugh at them, because I think it's just a face. And I think everyone deserves to be who they want to be, who they are. I think everyone needs to be able to wear the face they're comfortable with. You know, if you look good, then you feel good about yourself. When I was in the hospital, I wouldn't let them take my makeup off, because I said, at the worst time of your life, when you're coming out of anesthesia and you're feeling so terrible anyway, at least if you know you look halfway as decent, then you feel better about yourself.
You mean to tell me that you came out of the operation with makeup
totally
on?
Totally made up. And I didn't look sick. I didn't look like I'd been through anything. And that's the way I wanted it. I just want to know.
I have to ask you, what in the heck is the makeup a metaphor for? What does it really mean? Because, you know, it's really extreme.
It means nothing.
No, your makeup is extreme.
You think it
it's
is?
It's very extreme.
Well, Roseanne, yours is sort of like mine today. You just have a little less eyeliner on.
Well, I have false eyelashes.
You have false eyelashes
and everything. But, I mean, what does it mean to you?
Nothing.
It's like, no, it obviously means something. It obviously means something.
It probably deep down does somewhere, but I probably have to get a psychiatrist to dig it out. And I've never been to one, so I'm not too worried about it.
Do you think that you, I don't mean to disrespect you.
I just want
to know you.
I think I feel ugly without it. I think that's it. I feel ugly without it. I don't like to look at my own self in the mirror without it. And so I do it for me. I don't do it for you. I do it for me. And I feel prettier with it. And I think that if we feel pretty, then we'll act pretty. We'll, you know.
Yeah.
What I'm saying. I think how you look has a lot to do with who you are and what you are and what you become.
But if you think you look ugly without it...
I do.
Well, that's not the right way to think.
I know, Roseanne.
But you don't.
But that's the way I feel, you know.
But that's a wrong way to feel.
Okay.
I just have to tell you that.
Okay.
It's the wrong way to feel because you are a beautiful person inside of you. And so, you know, the stuff outside, are you trying to, like... Are you protecting yourself?
That could be.
You're putting so much stuff on your face that you're like hiding.
Is it really that much? Let me look.
It really is that much.
Man, you're making me not be able to breathe here.
Tammy, you are a woman who kicked cancer in the butt.
I kicked it right in the butt.
You got rid of cancer.
I did. When I found out I had cancer, I had been bleeding for a year. And everyone told me, the people that I went to, my gynecologist,
what kind of
which
cancer
was a woman, I had colon cancer. And they thought
did
it was...
Did you think that was happening for a year because of stress, or what?
I thought it was hemorrhoids. They told me that's what it was, that it was bleeding hemorrhoids. So I tried all the things that you would try with hemorrhoids, and it would help temporarily, but then it would come back. Well, when we started our own show, the Jim, Jay, and Tammy Faye Show, it got really, really bad. And so I knew I had to go to a proctologist. Which is every woman's worst nightmare, I think.
And man's.
And man's, probably. And so I would never go because I wouldn't go to a man. So I found the only living woman proctologist in captivity. And thank God it was a woman. The positions I had to get in. Now, if you go to a man, ladies, what you do is just put a bag over your head and two little holes for the eyes, and then they won't see your face. But I think mine knows me by my you-know-what by this time. But when I found out I had cancer, it never scared me, Roseanne. It really did not. I never had the first ounce of fear.
Well, wait a minute. I want to know how come it took you a year to go in.
Because I wouldn't go to a man. I couldn't find a woman.
Well, so were you in some kind of, like, were you thinking in your head, if I don't face it, it's not really here?
Probably.
Because I think that's what I would do.
Yeah, I was probably saying that. It's got to be hemorrhoids because nobody like me could ever get cancer. You always think it's always going to happen to somebody else.
Right.
It's not going to happen to you.
So then when you finally, you must have come to a point where you finally came
to a realization where I was bleeding so bad I got very afraid. And I found this woman and went to her. And by the time, of course, that I got to her, I had a large tumor in my colon and it was too late. And when the phone rang.
Hold on, because we're going to take a commercial. But when we come back, we're going to talk about what you did inside yourself to get rid of cancer, because I really, really admire you. I think
you're
a very strong and amazing woman. Tammy's going to tell us more about her bad times and what she's learned about forgiveness after this.
It keeps you all up and happy.
What were you going to show them? You have something.
Okay, they expected you last night at Phantom of the Opera.
Why? They thought you were going to come. Nobody even invited me.
I know. Well, they should because it's an awesome show. But I'll tell you, they expected you. So I thought I would go ahead and bring you a playbill to it. And then I was going to bring you whole things of M&Ms, but I got hungry and ate some of them. But they're good.
Thank you. Okay? I love M&Ms.
We both like candy. And I like the peanut ones. Do you like the peanut ones?
Yeah, let's eat some.
Okay.
Let me ask you, how do you say it? Woman to woman, girl to girl.
We're girl to girl.
Which one? Here. Which is harder?
I get green one.
Which is harder?
It's so fun to chew on television for everybody, isn't it?
Yeah.
How do you have a what is a television chew? Huh? I mean, to look like you're not chewing, but you really are.
Doesn't matter. Listen, which one was harder, Tammy Faye?
Yes.
Being crucified in the press or beating cancer? Which one?
You know, I think being crucified in the press was the hardest because it destroyed my reputation. And I valued my reputation above anything else. But you know, the Bible says that Jesus made himself of no reputation. And so losing my reputation, I shouldn't have worried about that. But I did because I felt like it would hinder me from doing things in the future, which I'm sure it has.
Like
beating cancer to me was, it was something I wasn't afraid of. Because, Roseanne, God made our bodies, and I trust God with me. And he has promised in the Bible that he will not put more on us than we can bear.
That's right.
And sometimes I've looked up and said, hey, God, you made a mistake. You know, you're going a little too far here. Pull back a bit, you know.
I know what that feels like.
Man.
I do know what that feels like.
But he promised that in his word, and I trust God's word. And so I said, okay, God, I trust you with me. So what I did, I know God heals people. But he doesn't always. I mean, you know, he has different ways of healing people. And I believe God gave doctors the common sense and the ability it takes to make you well.
Right.
So I went to the doctor and had the doctor operate on me. They took out 14 inches of my colon. And I don't wear a bag or anything. Thank God I have all of everything is intact, which I'm very grateful for, because being a woman, that would be very hard on me. And, you know, it's just not feminine. But if you have to live with it, it's better than dying.
Right.
The thing I found out about beating cancer is don't be afraid of it. It's all attitude. Because, you know, it's not how you face the circumstances in your life. It, I mean, it's not what happens in your life. It's how you react to it.
Well, what did
it's
you do?
It's not the circumstances.
Did you go someplace in your head that you never had been before?
No, I went right back to the one I always go to.
Oh.
I went back to God, and I said, God, I belong to you. And if it's time for me to go to heaven, okay. But if it's not, I'm going to work on this as hard as I can. I began to go on a good eating regimen. I went on all kinds of vitamins. I believe in vitamin therapy. I believe that it certainly can't hurt. If it doesn't help, it certainly can't hurt. And I think today so much of the good is taken out of our food.
But did you make a decision in your head, Tammy Faye, that you went, I'm going to beat this?
Yes. Oh, yes. And I decided I would beat it through laughter, through a good attitude, and not giving up and not letting it frighten me.
And it worked.
And it worked. And 3 years free of cancer. 3 years free.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Why do you think that you were allowed to live? Is there a reason that you were allowed to live?
I think I got lots of stuff to do.
Like what? What do you want
to
do?
Well, I have a real heart for teenagers. I really do. I love kids. And I feel that they have not been given a format and a way to get out and say what they feel in this world.
I think that too. I do.
And
too.
I would love to someday do a talk show with teenagers and just let them loose and let them be who they are. I want to go where they are. I want to go to the tattoo parlors. I want to go to the piercing parlors.
Well, no, your son's
I want to be
here.
Where they are.
Where's your boy? Because
stand
he's
up,
got
Jay.
He's got all pierced and tattooed.
Yeah,
in his
he is.
This is Tammy Faye's son, Jay. Stand up. I got four big kids.
Yeah.
So I've been through it all.
You've been through it all.
Oh, they're all pierced and tattooed.
I really think, you know, somebody says, well, I wouldn't have let my son do that. I said, listen, I picked my battles. And what they put on their skin or put through their skin is not really any of importance. What they are in here is what's important. And I hope that I've taught Jamie great values. And that's what the importance is. You know, my husband's a minister today. He's with Revolution, and he's a minister of the gospel. And that kid loves God, and he helps a lot of people that have tattoos and rings in their nose and rings in their ears and rings in their eyebrows.
And so do you.
Thank you.
You're a minister yourself.
Yes, I am. I'm an ordained minister.
You are an ordained minister.
Yes.
A lot of people don't know that about you, and
yes,
always think of you as like the wife behind the minister. But you yourself are a minister.
I am, yes.
So we want to hear you preach, and we want you to go over the organ and sing
for us. Well, I think I probably just preached a little bit.
Well, preach a little more over there in the organ. I'm going with you.
Yeah, who with me?
I want to sing with Tammy Faye. Who knew that Tammy Faye plays the organ? Did anybody know that?
Yeah.
from International Falls, Minnesota, was raised with 8 children. And Mom and all the kids used to sit around the piano, only know 2 keys, C and G. That's why Amazing Grace is a little high for me. But we used to sit around the piano and we used to sing the songs of the church. And that's where my foundation came from. And that is the firm foundation that has held me through every trial and test that I've been through. I love you.
Your own new show, Tammy Faye. I love you.
I love you too, Roseanne.
And when we come back, we're going to be joined by gay rights activist and author Chastity Bono, who is here to talk about her new book, Family Outing. So stay tuned.